Let f be a function that maps real numbers inputs to real numbers outputs. Then f satisfies the following functional equation for all real numbers x and y. Can you solve this functional equation? Or in other words, can you find all such functions with this property over here? This is a functional equation from the 2012 Kyrgyzstan National Olympiad. So I have two solutions here for you. Before we jump into the solution, you should always try and guess some solutions to this functional equation by trying some simple but potential answers like f of x is equal to c, where c is a constant, f of x is equal to x, and f of x is equal to kx plus c. What you will notice is that f of x is equal to x and f of x is equal to minus x are solutions to this functional equation. And this serves as a tool for us to check our answers later on. So to start, let's set x and y to be equal to 0. And there are terms that will vanish, leaving us with this following equation over here. This step in general is a good way to start solving functional equation because it makes terms to vanish. Then what we got here tells us that there is some real number value which I will let the inner term to be t, such that it is a root of function f. In other words, f of t is equal to 0. Then what we can do with this t value is that we can now set x is equal to t and y is equal to x, where x here is a free variable because I like to use x along these solutions. So we will have f of x is equal to x because the other terms disappear as f of t is equal to 0. Now what we have here is that such function f is called as an involution, where if you apply the function f twice to an input x, you get back the input. And what's great about this is that involution is bijective. In other words, f is both injective and surjective. To prove that f is injective, we will suppose that f of a is equal to f of b for some real numbers a and b. Then we can apply f both sides to get that f of a is equal to f of b. And so a is equal to b, because we have the property that if you apply f twice to x, you get back x for all real numbers x. Hence, f is injective. To prove that f is surjective, notice that for any real number s, I can take f of s as an input to f, such that if you apply f to it, you get back s. So for all image s in the set of real numbers, there is an object which is f of s, which will be mapped to s. This means that f is also surjective. Therefore, f is bijective. Now let's set x is equal to f of x and y to be a free variable in the given functional equation. We will get this equation, but notice that because of the property that f applied twice to x is equal to x, so replacing them as x, we have the following equation over here. But hey, the right hand side is still the same as the given functional equation. So we can say that t is equal to f of x squared plus f of y. Next, here comes the greatness of f being bijective. We can now remove the outer f both sides as f is injective. So we have that x squared plus f of y is equal to f of x squared plus f of y, which implies that f of x is equal to plus or minus x for every x. We can conclude that f of x is equal to x and f of x is equal to negative x are the only solutions and we are done, right? Well, not so fast. The problem here is that we only know that f of x could be x or minus x, meaning that x can be mapped to x for some real values of x and then mapped to negative x for a different set of values of x. So we actually don't know whether f can change its sign or not. This is a common trap in solving functional equation, which is sometimes called as the pointwise trap. And to resolve this is to assume that there exists some real numbers a and b such that f of a is equal to a and f of b is equal to negative b. Notice that they have opposite signs. Then we'll deduce that one of them must be 0. In other words, the function must be either f of x is equal to x for all x or f of x is equal to negative x for all x, where there is no change of sign. So setting x is equal to a and y is equal to b into our given functional equation, we have that f of a squared minus b is equal to a squared plus b. And then we have two possibilities. F of a squared minus b is a squared minus b or negative a squared plus b. Well, in either case, you can check that what you get is that one of a and b must be equal to 0. We solve our problem. Therefore, this means that f of x is equal to x and f of x is equal to negative x are indeed the only solutions to this functional equation over here. Now, here comes another solution that does not deal with the pointwise trap. We first proceed just like in the first solution, where we set x and y to be 0, and we will get f of t is equal to 0. Then setting x is equal to t and y is equal to x, we get this property which is f applied twice, we get back x. Now, in particular, notice that f of 0 is equal to 0. Because f is bijective, as we have argued previously, this means that f of 0 must be equal to t. And t is actually also equal to f of 0 squared plus f of 0. Cancelling out the f of 0, this gives f of 0 must be 0. Next, we set x is equal to f of x and y to be equal to 0. We will end up with this equation. And because of the property that f of x is equal to x, this simplifies into f of x squared is equal to x times by f of x. More importantly, if we change the sign of x to be negative x, like setting x is equal to f of negative x and y is equal to 0, and doing the same simplification, we get that f of x squared is equal to negative x times by f of negative x. Comparing these two equations relating f of x squared, we see that negative x times by f of negative x is equal to x times by f of x. So dividing out x, we get f of negative x is equal to negative of f of x, which means that f is an odd function. And you may ask about what happens when x is equal to 0, since we are dividing by x. Well, then it doesn't matter since f of 0 is equal to 0 already, and it satisfies the oddness property. We can then set x is equal to f of x and y is equal to f of y, like what we have just did, and then using the fact that f of x is equal to x again, we get f of x squared plus y is equal to f of x times by x plus f of y. But now, x times by f of x is equal to f of x squared. So f of x squared plus y is just f of x squared plus f of y. Then letting z to be x squared, where z can be any non-negative real number, we see that f of z plus y is equal to f of z plus f of y for all non-negative real number z and real number y. This is an important property that we are going to use. Next, I'm going to do a trick, which is to take x is greater than or equal to 0. And note that if we take the input to be x plus 1, the whole thing squared in f, it is equal to x plus 1 times by f of x plus 1. We can expand the inner term of the left-hand side, which is just this. And then we can split this into three terms by using the fact that we had just derived just now. But this is the same thing as x times by f of x plus 2 times by f of x plus f of 1, using those properties that we have just derived. Well, you can check them as an exercise. Then the right hand side is the same thing as x plus 1, the whole thing times by f of x plus f of 1. And expanding it, it will give us this expression over here. Now we can cancel the identical terms x times by f of x, and f of 1, leaving us with f of x is equal to x times by f of 1. Finally, we can use the fact that f applied twice is equal to x to solve for f of x by setting x to be f of 1 in f of x is equal to x times by f of 1. So we have that x is equal to f of x times by f of 1 or f of x is equal to x over f of 1. This just gives us f of 1 is equal to plus or minus 1. But not forgetting that x is greater than or equal to 0 here. And to obtain the values for x is less than 0, we can apply the odd property of function f, which means that f of x is indeed just x for all real number x or negative x for all real numbers x. And this is the second way to solve this functional equation over here. Now, if you have reached here, make sure to subscribe to the channel for more math videos. And click the video on the screen right now to solve more functional equations, and I'll see you in that video.